Hey guys, I'm back with another YouTube video, and as promised, I'll be showing you guys some 3D flowers, and I'm also going to be showing you guys how I like to pick up my beads for my two-tone flowers. For my large bead, I'm going to wipe my brush once on the side of my dapping dish and lightly go into my white powder twice before completely submerging the bead in my blue powder. So I'm going to do another large size bead, and remember that when you're picking up beads for 3D art, especially your flowers, you really only want the acrylic on the very tip of the brush. So you'll have to hold your brush at a high angle. You guys are also going to see that my beads are coming out the same exact size. Also, this 3D brush is not the 3D brush I'm going to use for my flowers. I actually lost it right before I recorded this section of the video, so you guys will be seeing a different brush, but I will link both down below. Next, for my medium sized bead, I'm going to wipe my brush off twice, and I'm only going to go into my white and blue powder one time for each. Now, when I'm going into my white powder, I'm actually holding it for a quick second, but when you're dipping in for your blue powder, regardless of the side of the bead, you just want to make sure you're getting the color on there. I'm not really adding too much product on with my other color. Also, it's best for you to work on a flat surface, and that's why you guys see me shake my powders out after I was dipping my brush in there 1001 times. Lastly, for my smallest bead, I did wipe my brush off 3 times before I started to go into my powder. This way, I removed most of the liquid from the brush, but these beads are gonna come out real small, and I actually made this one kind of ugly. For my first petal, I'll be picking up a large bead, and I'm gonna first place my brush in my white acrylic and then my purple to give it this look. So you do not want to immediately place your bead onto the nail after you pick it up from the powder, because it's still going to be wet, so I am allowing it to dry a little bit by tapping it on the edge of my acrylic jar until I feel like it's ready, and for the most part, if it's ready, it'll start to be shiny. After placing down my bead, I'm going to use the very tip of my brush to create my petal by pushing down towards the stones. And when you're doing this, if your acrylic is starting to bounce back up, that just means it's a little too wet right now, and you can just do it again. Since I want this flower petal to be larger, I'm going to continue to press down on the center of the bead. Now that I'm done making the petal larger, I'm going to come to the bottom of the petal and bring the sides in by lightly pushing against both sides of the petal to create a point. For this petal, I'll be doing the same thing. And guys, remember that you do not want your beads to be too wet. So now I'm pressing down towards the center once again. And when I'm doing this, my brush isn't flat. It is slightly at an angle, because if you do start to hold your brush flat as you're doing this, you're gonna continue to make the bead larger. Once the petal is large enough to my liking, once again, I'm gonna use the very tip of my brush to bring in the sides. And if I feel like it's a little too skinny, I'll go back in the center and widen it out before I go back and bring the sides in once again. The petals in the middle is actually going to be smaller, but I'm still going to be using the same method when I'm picking up my two-tone bead. Remember that when you're doing this, you do not want the acrylic to touch the stones, because it's not going to look as clean. Now I'm using the tip of my brush to create the petal, and like I said earlier, if it's too wet, your acrylic is gonna bounce back up. So you may have to do this more than once if you did not allow your acrylic to dry enough. So I will be doing this to the next two petals, and if you guys want to see more flower design videos in the future, please let me know down below, because I only got three different designs for y'all now, and I had to show y'all this because I think the last time I gave y'all a 3D video, it was about maybe a few months ago, maybe almost a year ago, and fall time is here. People want to see those flowers. It's gonna match perfectly with all your fall sets, so I do recommend going ahead and adding this onto your freestyle. So like I said, if you guys are interested in seeing more 3D flower videos or just more design videos, let me know down below. Once I was finished with my flower, I did also go in and add some more stones, and I will link all of the acrylic colors I used in this video down below. Y'all gonna love this design, and like I said, I will link everything I use in this video down below, and y'all go check out my Amazon store because most of the products I use are there as well. When I am placing my beads for my flowers, remember that you do not want to place your acrylic too close to the stones, because if you start to create your petal and the acrylic is touching the stones, it's not going to give it a very clean look. So just remember that you don't want your acrylic to touch the stones, and you can prevent this by placing the petal away from the stone. And then when you're pressing down, you'll just slowly move the acrylic towards the stone, which it really shouldn't take much if you don't place it too far back. Thank you. Even though I showed you the acrylic ratio that I like to use when it comes to my 3D art, I still would say that you should find your own, simply because this is how you're going to be able to make sure all of your petals are the same size. For example, if I wipe my brush on my dapping dish twice and only stay in my white and blue powder for 1 second each, I'm gonna make sure I do the same exact thing to the rest of my petals, because you don't want your flower to be all lopsided. And y'all can't even lie and say this color scheme is not the cutest. Also, I'm pretty sure I told you guys that I passed my state board exam and I'm officially a licensed nail tech. If you guys are interested in hearing my story, I did post a video where I was talking about my experience taking my state board test, and I also took a shot for some celebration. Also, you guys, I do want to post more videos in a week, so if you guys would like to give me some suggestions that I could just do on my practice hand instead of doing on an actual client, feel free to comment your suggestions. If you guys would like more short tutorials between like my actual tutorials dealing with clients, I have no problem with doing that. I have more free time to dedicate to you guys, so feel free to comment some suggestions. Like, I would really appreciate the help. Also, all of the acrylic that I'm using for my base is from Nail Supply Glamour, and I do have a code, which is Top Beauty, and I'm gonna link everything down below, so y'all go get y'all some acrylic. They're not too expensive, and that discount gonna help y'all out. Now for my last petal, watch how it's just gonna perfectly fit into the spot, and when I create my petal, it's not gonna be smushed on the side. This is because, like I said, I made sure that all of my petals were the same size, and your placement means everything. Here, I did decide to add some stones, and I'm not using my Zule bling glue because this is a practice finger and I did not want to use my good glue, knowing that I'm just gonna put this nail to the side once I'm finished. So I'm just using my regular KDS glue for the stones. So now I'll be creating half flowers going up and along the nail, and you guys would be surprised on how many times I do 3D flowers in a week. If you guys actually go on my Instagram page, which I will be leaving down below, you guys can see that using the same method, I've created a bunch of different types of design. And I will also link my original 3D flower video down below if you guys are interested in seeing that as well. Also, how often do you guys normally practice? I've been trying to practice for at least 30 minutes a day. I prefer to do it in the morning so I can just get it out the way, just so that I'm constantly staying up with trends, because sometimes I feel like I'm not doing as much, or I can be doing more trends, or I'm not taking the time to learn new skills. So I just wanted to know, how often do you guys like to practice? Also, if you guys have learned anything from this video as well as any other videos and would like for me to share your work on my Instagram, I have no problem with doing so. So feel free to DM me, even if you guys decide to recreate any of these flowers. Tag me in the post and I will reshare it. Last but not least, this flower is very similar to the first flower, but this time we'll be creating the other half. So by mistake, I did not realize that I wasn't recording that side of the flower. So I'm just gonna do the opposite side, because I really still wanted y'all to see this, even though it's very similar to the first flower. I also prefer to do the outer petals first, just so that when I'm placing my petal in the middle, if it does have to be a little smaller, there won't be any issues, because I know that the ones on the outer side are the same size. Also, if you guys did not know from my last video, I did post some acrylic toes. And for the acrylic toe videos, I extended her toenails without using nail tips or forms. So if you guys are interested in that video, I will leave that down below. And if you guys want to see more videos like that, leave a comment and a like. So this is all that I have for you guys today, and if you did enjoy this video, please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'm gonna see you guys in the next video.